Emerging from their tunnel, and we are ready for football as the Cards get set to match up with the Kansas City Chiefs. And all the Chiefs have it. Williams is going to have the first down and a little more. And down right around the 37. They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down. Looking to throw is Mahomes. Flushed out right. Throw right side, complete to Williams. It's a gain of 5, and that'll bring up second down.
I like it, I like it, I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game, and you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so, and gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it and really gets them amped up as they go forward.
Second down, it's Williams, and they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. That one, a first down pickup of 8. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
Williams. And not much. Maybe a yard down to the 23.
No doubt about it. Really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
On second down now, it's Williams, and he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. First and goal, a chance for an early statement here on the road. They'll try and run. This is Williams, and he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Darrell Williams, a 9-yard touchdown run, and the Chiefs are going to take a first quarter lead. Extra point by Butker is on target, and that makes the score 7-0. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And Moore, he's going to sit up. This one, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. Murray and the Cardinals with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. To throw is Murray. That's out to the flat for Edmonds. Edmonds a first down and more. There he goes, right side. Well, and this is where quarterbacks' passing numbers sometimes get a little bit more inflated than they should, because this is a short little pass, but it goes for big yardage.
Yeah, and this just looked like a simple, ordinary play to start, but boy, did things change. Once he got free, it was off to the races, and once he hit high gear, there's absolutely no one who was going to stop him.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. Well, here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because
throw across his body and it's intercepted. Isaiah Simmons picking it off. And they're going to be set up in the red zone right around the 17-yard line.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage, but instead he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
After the turnover, here's Murray. Caught by the tight end Ertz. Touchdown! Zach Ertz from 17 yards out, and the Cardinals have taken the lead.
Well, we know someone just added to his touchdown passing total, but all he did was get the ball out quickly to his tight end and let him take care of business the rest of the way.
Now Prater to add the PAT. It's up and good, and it's 14-7 now here in the first quarter. Touchdown, out is Prater to kick. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And last time, one play, interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling, because a one-play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
Second and 10. Working from the gun, Mahomes, flush to his right. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 23 yards the pickup there. Georgia Southern man. This is Jerick McKinnon. And he'll get it across midfield and down to the Cardinal territory. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. They stay on the ground. This time it's Williams. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a 3rd and 4. Here's Mahomes to throw. And going deep for Hill. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Tyreek Hill, 46 yards. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying up this football game.
One thing that we know for sure, do not question the arm strength of Patrick Mahomes, one of the strongest around.
And that is absolutely demoralizing for a defense because you've got the offense on the ropes. It's 3rd down. You're trying to get off the field and then wham. You have a letdown in the secondary, and you give up a big one.
And he's going to be taken down. It's a sack and a big sack at that. This remains a one-point game. Now after the touchdown, here's Butker on to kick it away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Escape and a big loss here as he's taken down. After the sack, oh, they're staring at a challenge basically from the other side of town. It's second and a country mile. And that is incomplete. Nearly intercepted. The free safety couldn't quite get his hands around it, and it brings up third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Play action. Now it's Murray. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. A real letdown defensively. That was third and a bundle, but they allow the conversion. So that play much needed there as they're all the way up near the 40 for a first and 10. On play action, it's Murray. And he is going to go down. They sack him on the final play of the first quarter. We are in for a good one as we're through one on EA Sports. Second and 21. A lot of ground to cover. Another try after the first down sack. Murray going deep for Hopkins. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. That goes for a gain of 31. Well, make that now two completions for him on this drive, and these aren't ordinary completions. They're big ones.
Yeah, these are the types that make a secondary talk to each other and not in a good way, oftentimes pointing fingers. Hey, who's got him? Someone cover him. That type of indecision can open up even more big plays.
Throwing on first down is Murray. Zach Ertz has it complete. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. They scored touchdowns on drives one and two, and now they're trying to make it a perfect 3-for-3 to start. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cardinals. James Conner there to make the grab. And the Cardinals push further out in front. Extra point good by Prater. And the lead is up to 8. After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. They start the drive on the ground. It's Williams. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's second down. Second and 6. Mahomes now to throw.
And this throw incomplete. And the defender all over him that time, and it's going to lead to third down.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Throwing is Mahomes on third. He is going to find Hill here. And he will have a Chiefs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Now a first down carry. It's Williams. And he'll lose yardage here. Going down back at the 28. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
They have three tight ends in that formation. That's almost a universal sign that they're planning to run the football. But how about the defense there? They met force with force and caused a stack up behind the line of scrimmage and threw him for a loss.
On second and 11 now, Mahomes. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's third down.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. To throw, it's Mahomes. And this pass broken up. And the contact well timed there, and now fourth down.
I like what they tried to do there. Tried to hit him with something quick, get the ball in his hands, and hope he could make some yards after the catch and pick up a first down. Weren't able to do so on that play.
Mahomes in the offense staying out there. They'll go for it on fourth. Mahomes going to go on fourth down. And this one caught by Travis Kelce. And they do finally get him, but he takes it to the 25. And CD, we have seen some great runs the last few times we've been together, but I think we can at least put this one in our top five. That was a determined gallop there. Man open is Robinson. And in for the Chiefs touchdown. DeMarcus Robinson, 25 yards for the touchdown. And the Chiefs are a two-point conversion away from tying this thing up.
On this play, he just made a great route. The quarterback had to deliver it, sure, but a great route run there.
And, Brandon, this is what the best receivers do. They work on their route running because it's one thing to have athletic ability, but to really get open, you have to set up defensive backs with different routes and be precise in your cuts.
And around the goal line, especially on two-point tries, sometimes the QB's best friend is that big target, the tight end.
I love how you described it, because you know he's going to have some length and some catch radius, as well as a big body to keep people away from the football.
It is fielded right at the goal line. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. Arizona's offense at the line, ready to get their drive started.
Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive that culminated in a touchdown, I think they carry that confidence into this one. Doesn't matter where you start with the football now, they have to feel great about their opportunity.
A reminder coming up here at halftime, we'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have first half highlights and analysis from a back and forth first half that we've seen. And he's going to lose a yard or two, taken down behind the line.
It was Frank Clark that time who got in there to bring him down.
So, Charles, no turnovers yet for this offense, but those sacks now, they're starting to pile up.
And one thing usually leads to another because they've got to figure out how the offensive line and everyone else involved in protection can keep their quarterback upright and allow him a chance to throw the ball downfield.
And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. Play fake, Murray. He'll get this complete to Rondale Moore. And this will set them up nicely deep down in KC territory. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. From the red zone, here's the Heisman Trophy winner, Murray. Trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. Picked up by Juan Thornhill. And the Chiefs are going to have the football here at their own 18-yard line.
Well, they were in a great position to take the lead, Charles. Obviously, all they needed was a field goal to do that. They wanted the touchdown. Unfortunately, they're going to get neither.
And you know every offense talks about the same thing each week, don't they, Brandon? They want to end every drive with a kick, whether it's a field goal attempt, a point after the touchdown, or at worst, a punt. This time they had that opportunity but didn't get it because you know the field shrinks that close to the end zone, and that allows the defense to tighten up their coverage, and they pick that one off.
So after the INT, here's Mahomes. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Well, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he was standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. Here's second and 10. Going to throw. And incomplete on the deep ball.
I know at times people think we use it too often, but you've got to be able to throw guys open. And when you read zone, you've got to stick it in there before your receiver gets to the next guy in the zone. Otherwise, you bring him into the play.
And that's precisely what allowed that defense to disrupt the pass. From the gun on third down, Mahomes. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. Now the Cards going to call another timeout, their second, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Here's the Chiefs punter now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. Take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A good return there, 17 yards. And there'll be time for maybe one final play before halftime. A final shot before half for Murray. Sliding out of the pocket. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
With both of these offenses having their way, it's not likely they'll need to be doing a whole lot at halftime. But the defenses are definitely in need of some adjusting. And for the call of the second half, let's go back out to Brandon and Charles.
And we welcome you back now. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I'm thinking they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie.
Well, Mahomes can't get away, and down he goes. J.J. Watt that time able to do what he does best, and that sacked the quarterback. Following the sack, they'll try to change their fortune here on second and 13. Another try after the first down sack. Mahomes, under pressure, they got him again. J.J. Watt able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening.
Now that's the way to start the second half. Back-to-back sacks. Whatever the halftime speech was, I hope they recorded it.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. So stop here defensively to start this third quarter. Just what's needed in a tie ball game.
Yeah, good chance to build back some momentum on the defensive side of the ball. In fact, what they've done is give their offense a nice push in the back as they get ready to take the field.
Here's the Chiefs punter now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Kirk now, the return man. That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And the Cards will take over, first and 10. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively. Just not able to get anything going, so what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each play work. Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run. They fake the handoff. Now Murray. And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Another try after the first down sack. Murray dancing to his left. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
Murray with a third and long. This one grabbed by A.J. Green. They'll wind up with 17 on that one, but they're still a bit short here for fourth. They're going for it. It's Murray. And this is Ertz with it, right side. And he gets the first down here as he's taken down at the 24. And the drive stays in motion with a nice 8-yard pickup on fourth. On first and 10, here's Murray. Finding Ertz again. And he is out of bounds, looks like right at the 15. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
They'll look to run with Connor. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. Three quarters in the books.
We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. They'll go again from the three here on second and goal. To throw is Murray. Eluding the pressure right. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Here's Murray. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Anthony Hitchens able to finally wrestle him down for what's just going to be a huge loss, and it takes us to fourth down as well.
Now that was something, and it wasn't good. In one play, you've gone from being in the red zone to maybe out of field goal range. Totally inexcusable.
Prater's kick is good. And they have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter.
Well, he was a spectator for much of this game. This is his first field goal opportunity of the entire contest, but he's able to connect.
Yeah, he had a pretty good seat to this one, didn't he? But let's face it, all kickers that you and I know, they want to contribute. They want their opportunity, and he seized his.
Prater now will send it away following the main field goal. This is going to be returned from middle of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And now they find themselves trailing following the field goal. Still a good amount of time in this fourth quarter, but this drive very well could determine the outcome of this ballgame. And he'll be marked down at the 26 with a gain of 7.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
On second down, Williams. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll run it with Williams. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. They'll run on first down. Williams. Some extra space following the display of power. Down just inside the 45. Second down, it's Williams, and he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. From the gun, it's a run for Williams. Williams is going to have the first down and a little more, and all the way down to the 17-yard line.
107 yards on the ground for him now as he's gotten better, really, as the night's gone on.
First down, Williams. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. They come up on a second down now in a game that looks like it's going to go down the wire. And he'll fight his way down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. This will be play number 8 here on the drive. It's third and a yard. The busy night continues for Williams. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee. And that means fourth down.
down. It's Williams. And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down. Mahomes. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked off inside the five. And the Cards have just about sewn up this football game. Just when you thought this game might be turned on its ear, a late interception pretty much going to seal the deal.
Yeah, boy, talk about having your backs to the wall. This defense, they were in danger of surrendering this lead, but they knew they needed that one play, and they got it right there, partner.
The drive will start with Connor. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds left to play. Right back to Connor here on first. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Back to throw, Murray. Going deep for Hopkins. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Legarius Sneed. And the Chiefs are right back in this football game. Oh my, how the tables have turned now. They were trying to salt this one away, but that interception, potentially a game changer.
And I've just got to think to myself, at this point of the game, I know you've been aggressive. I know that's your MO, and that's fine. And all those teams that talk about all gas, no brakes, you better have the emergency lever to pull occasionally. They could have used it right there. They put themselves in a tough spot with that interception.
And unable to connect. It's incomplete. And the clock stopped at 8 seconds.
Work with me, partner. Take a deep breath, because that's what they're doing down the field now. That incompletion allowed them to exhale a little bit. Get in the huddle, kind of scan the crowd, see if any celebrities are here. Relax a little bit as they start this big drive.
Well, Mahomes can't get away, and down he goes. A costly sack. They'll have to use a timeout here. And barring a defensive penalty, they'll be looking at one final play. Try for Mahomes. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over. Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end.
Tables and turn. Forget the bridge we don't build. This time I let them all burn. They try to kill me out. Well, now it's the word. I bring it paper, paper, paper from the first to the first. They count me out. Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling. Can't even see him from the view. Got my check up, and now I'm trying to blow a bag of two. Proud to shoot, and all designer drip get what I desire. Put him out, what I told him, cause that boy he on fire. Walk in that thing and air it up, been in my bag a little bit. Remember my pockets in a jar, I couldn't put a little chick. They said it to the left of paper. You see that's a myth. Why you catch all my brothers balling and shooting no brick. Hold up, check me out. Hold up, I think the tables will turn. Forget the bridge that we don't build, this time I let them all burn. They try to count me out. Well, now it's the word. I bring in paper, word? Paper, paper from the first to the first. They count me out. Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot.
one thing. Ding, 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 sustain, sustain. Rackays, rackays, hit the paint. Ba-bang, ba-bang, put you in your place. Wait, they done got me started. Without me, it's not a party.
Nope.
Mahi got it rocking. We bring heaven to your lobby. Tristan, he got shoddy. They gon' cop because we poppin'. Blues up in my wallet. If I like it, then I cop it.
Hold up, check me out.
Hold up.
I think the tables and turn.
Forget the bridge that we done built. This time I let them all burn.
They tried to count me out.
Well, now it's the word.
I bring
it
word.
paper from the first to the first.
They count me out,
yeah, yeah.
Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot, sizzling.
They
count me out,
nah, nah.
It all begins
right here,
right now. Catch me if you can.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League takes us to the City of Angels, Los Angeles, California. Tonight, we've got a good NFC matchup in store between the Dallas Cowboys and the Los Angeles Rams. And we are underway from SoFi Stadium. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee. As he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Off of play action, here's Stafford. Got a man open. It's Tyler Higbee. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. A good start offensively. 15 yards on the game's initial play. And he'll work this one up to about the 38. Working with a second and three.
A 7-yard pickup.
Now a play fake at Stafford.
At the 38-yard line.
And the pressure gets to him and brings him down. Stafford is sacked. Micah Parsons able to run him down for a loss of 12 that time. So now Stafford and the Rams after the sack. And they're staring up at a third and long. Third and long, it's Stafford. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. And he's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds. So a big call there that brings up fourth. Okay, look at this. The punt team nowhere to be found. They're on the sidelines. Offense going to go for this on the opening drive. And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Oh, a big decision here early. Look at this. They're going to go for it on their own side of the field. Here we go on fourth. Stafford. Got a man. It's Higbee complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Hey, nothing to see here. Just your standard fourth down gain of 28 yards. And the drive keeps going. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 47. A shotgun snap for Stafford. Going up top for Kupp. And he's got it. What a catch on the sideline. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain.
Brandon, we've both been around the game long enough that we know that in pregame, defenses are pretty amped up, aren't they? I mean, they're pounding lockers, and they can't wait to get out there. But when you hit them with some big pass plays early, it takes the starch right out of them.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down.
Let's get off the field. Mike 14.
Stafford. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down.
Chances are good he's going to be a very busy guy. Two catches already in his opening drive, and they were looking his way for a third.
I think they put this defense on notice that that could be a really, really frequent combination.
They'll fake the give. Now Stafford. And his throw is incomplete.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on third down.
This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. Throwing again at Stafford. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on third down.
Matt Gay for the Rams field goal. A 33-yard attempt.
And Gay knocks this one through. And the Rams have the first points here. It's 3-0. So the opening drive does yield points, maybe not the 7 they wanted, but they'll take the 3.
Accumulating first downs does not go up on the scoreboard, but it does go into the DNA of a team that's trying to establish itself to start a game. That has to feel pretty good for them. They'll take the 3.
Yeah, they had 3 first downs and 3 points.
At their own 18-yard line.
So Prescott of the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 18. Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2.
He was brought down at the 26. 8 yards.
Elliott going to get it again on second down. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. That second down play, that's a minus 4. Prescott from the gun on third. He'll get this out wide here to Elliott. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. From the 32 now. Here's first and 10. Out of the gun, it's Elliott. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
That's a play to take note of there for the defense. I think in the future, if you're going to try and block him, maybe you get a guard to help double team him and try and steer him out of the play. They should have done it on that snap.
After the loss, they'll come up second and 13. On play action, Prescott. A dump off to Elliott. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Play action now, Prescott. Got an open man, it's Michael Gallup. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. They give him a gain of 38.
A very early momentum changer there. Actually a dream killer for the defense because they forced a third down. Felt like they had a good chance to get off the field defensively, and then they got hit with that big play.
Cowboys nothing.
A first down carry by Elliott. And only a yard this time as he's taken down right around the 26. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run.
Brings up second and 9 at the Rams 26-yard line.
Throwing, Prescott. And this one quickly to Lamb. Touchdown, Cowboys! CeeDee Lamb, 26 yards. And the Cowboys have taken the lead.
Partner, remember that old film of Peyton Manning going through the route tree with his great receivers in Indianapolis? I think we're seeing the results of the same type of work here today. These guys know each other so well that they don't even have to call the play. They can just look each other and know the route that's going to be run, and usually the connection is perfect.
Now Mike McCarthy saying, let's go for two. They'll let Elliott try and run it in. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down.
Well, they couldn't be happy that they were having to stop a two-point conversion because that means they gave up a touchdown. But a little solace there. You saw some good gang tackling, stacking him up before he gets to the end zone.
We talk about offensive units putting in more two-point period sessions in practice. Defensively, do you do the same?
Absolutely. You have to, because you never know how aggressive these offenses are going to be in games nowadays.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And a methodical drive last time, but they couldn't get that knockout blow. They had to settle for three.
But you got to like what they've been doing along the way, right? It's almost like the body blows, the setup punch. As you said, they didn't get the knockout blow here, but that doesn't mean it can't come later in the game on another possession. And the defense on the other side.
Maybe a little gas,
yeah,
right?
A little tired. And if nothing else, they just feel relieved getting up.
And the pressure gets to him and brings him down. Stafford is sacked. Osa Odigizawa. What an effort from him on that play. Big tackle for a loss of 11. After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
And able to find Higby. It's complete. And he'll be out right at the 35. How about that? They weather the storm of a third and 17 to pick up the first.
First and 10 at the 35-yard line.
Out of the gun, Stafford. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. A good pickup there, 26 yards. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 39-yard line. Stafford hooking up with Akers. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets it down to the 30 there. Here's a run with Akers on second down. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. They had to settle for three last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in six. In good position, first and 10. Meanwhile, Stafford's throw pulled in by Woods. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. From the gun, here's Stafford. Flushed out right. Touchdown, Rams! Odell Beckham from 10 yards out. And the Rams are going to jump back in front.
This has to be great for the psyche of this offense. Presented with bad field position, they didn't let it stop them. They rolled downfield and scored a touchdown.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that will make this a four-point game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. On the return, Tony Pollard from his end zone.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, It's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down. Play fake. Here's Prescott. He rifles one that's intercepted. Taylor Rapp with a pick. And the Rams are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line. Good starting field position for him as they come up first and 10 at their 38. After the interception, here's Stafford. Eventually, he's taken down here. Great coverage downfield, resulting in the sack. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. Another try after the first down sack. Stafford, he'll let it go deep for Beckham. He's got a man complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. It's a gain of 35. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Stafford still here, hauled in by Kupp. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. They still need about the length of the football here, maybe a little less as they come up on second and inches. Stay 50. They'll fake it. Now Stafford. He completes it to Beckham. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. So three plays already first and goal, and they are wasting little time. A quick throw complete out to Beckham. That's good for a gain of 6, second and goal. They'll look to run with Akers. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the 6. The Rams going to be forced to use their third and final timeout as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. Play action. Stafford. And he's going to be dropped. Back at the 15-yard line. Just not much a quarterback can do there, CD. The pressure was in his face almost instantaneously, led to a very quick sack. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of this first half of play. So we've reached halftime here in a 4-point game. As we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
Both these teams, no doubt, making their final halftime adjustments as we speak. And for the call of the second half, we get it back out to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number 3. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden. It's the Cowboys who get the football first, and they trail here as well as we resume action in the third quarter. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. It's been a tight game to this point. What do they need to do, Charles, to break through in the second half and take the lead?
Well, I think the first thing they need to do is thank their defense for keeping them in this game. You know what I think the defense is saying back to them? Why don't you guys focus on getting some first downs, put some drives together, give us a little bit of a break here. If we can get some rest, we'll play even better for you. And, oh, by the way, pay off a few of those drives with some points, too.
To throw on second and 10, Prescott. Flush to his right. That one complete, Elliott. And some room to maneuver. Touchdown, Cowboys! Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
Well, we know that he can beat you in a number of ways. He can catch the short passes. He can run under a long pass. Or he can do what we saw right there, catch one and then make a big gain after the catch.
And I think this is what the early proponents of the forward pass were thinking about. Get it to a receiver and have him do some work afterwards in order to create the big play we just saw there.
They'll let Elliott try and run it in. And this time he'll be stopped short of the goal line. He might have been out of gas after the long run. In any event, the try for two fails. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And that's going to leave them with just one timeout remaining still in the third quarter. We'll see if that comes back to haunt them. We'll be back. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the upmen. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And they're on the short end of the scoreboard here. Charles, what adjustments, if any, do you think they need to make for the second half?
Well, paraphrasing the gold medal hockey winning coach Herb Brooks, I just say you continue to play your game. Throw the ball. They had success doing it in the first half. So make sure you keep getting the ball to your playmakers. A little bit more to the perimeter, perhaps.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked up by DeMonte Kazee. And the Cowboys will have the football as this is taken up past the 30.
Partner, when you're playing cover two, this is like a tag team for the safeties. Each of them gets a half-field responsibility. Their job, stay as deep as the deepest receiver in any zone, read the football, and go make a play. In this case, the free safety made the best play, an interception.
He takes this from the 30 to the 34. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six.
4 yards on the pickup.
Now Prescott escaping the pressure right. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
On third down, it's Prescott. Forced out to his left. And he'll just get rid of it. So it doesn't look like they're going to be able to build off the turnover.
Well, the defense certainly did its part. It got them the football. But you're exactly right. It looks like they're going to have to punt this one away. And it's not a turnover, but doesn't it feel like one after grabbing the momentum with the defensive play?
Yeah, and they had all that momentum after getting the football and now zapped right back in the other direction. Dak and the offense still out there. They are going to go for it. Fourth down, Prescott, eluding the pressure right. Open man, Lamb, it's complete. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. The conversion is successful with a sizable gain of 13, and the decision to go for it looks like a smart one. Flushed out right. Wide open, Amari Cooper. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A well-executed 22-yard gain. From the shotgun, a give to Elliott.
And he's going to get this one down to the 30.
Now it's second and nine. Here's Prescott. Flush to his right. And he'll be forced out of bounds, shy of the line of scrimmage, so that'll be credited as a sack.
That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
Now Prescott. And that's Elliott, complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10.
And the Cowboy first down.
They'll run on first down. It's Elliott. And he'll get about three as he's taken down at the 14-yard line. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Prescott to throw it. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete.
And the Cowboys are going to be set up with a first and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line.
Second and goal.
No gain on the play. Leads to second and goal. No gain on second and goal.
Here's Prescott. The quick slant caught. 5 yards that time on the completion, and now it's third and goal.
Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. And that makes it a 9-point game.
Makes the score Cowboys 19, Rams 10. Greg Zuerlein to kick off for Dallas.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line.
And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by 2 scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical.
And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Throwing a Stafford. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield.
Over the middle, complete. It's Woods. They had a good job defensively. They stopped him short of the first at the 32. Desperation time for Stafford on fourth down. Looking for Woods again, and he finds him. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. Off the fake to Akers, here's Stafford. And did he get the feet down? No, they'll say he did not. It's incomplete.
They're down two scores, and they need a quick one to try and get back into this one. That was one way to try and get it done. Unsuccessful in the attempt, but they have no choice but to keep trying.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Stafford looks to throw again. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on. Well, you won't hear any boos from this home crowd on that call.
No, not at all. And it's been a long day for this crowd waiting for this game. It's been a long evening as well. Finally, they feel they got a call.
On first down at Stafford. Escaping the pressure right. Yeah, he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down. Late in the game, defense trying to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into a run, pick up the first, and stop the clock as well.
And you know, in this situation, everything is sped up. The intensity, the thinking, everyone's movement. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to be what we call a flatliner. Level in everything he does and read the clock, feel it in the pocket, and go at the appropriate time.
And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far at second down.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. To throw is Stafford. Going up top for Kupp. And this one is incomplete.
It's been clear in this matchup which side has been the more physical one. It's been this defense. And here's another example on that last play. 10 yards to go.
The Rams on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This is third and 10. Stafford. He'll get this to Akers out of the backfield. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. The Rams, they are on the move. They've got another first down. And in a two-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified. Big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible. Switch.
All right, boys, here we go. From the red zone now, Stafford. And he just throws this one away. That was a bit strange, and here comes the flag. In the pocket, chucked it away, flag comes down.
So you got to move a little bit, right? Know where you are on the field, have some awareness. Tackle to tackle. You got to get outside of that tackle box in order to get that done.
And he's going to be taken down, back around the 35-yard line. Osa Odigizawa, his second sack of the night. The Rams on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This will be third and a mile. Now a play fake it at Stafford. Going up top for Kupp. And he's got it. That's Kupp for a Ram touchdown. Cooper Kupp. 35 yards, and the Rams have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. On the return, Tony Pollard from his end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
For most people, the excitement of a kickoff return is to see a long one that goes back in the opposite direction. But for the guys covering it, it's being able to stop them deep in their own territory. How about that incredible form tackle right there? Shoulder in the ball carrier, and down he goes.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. After the touchdown we just saw, we have a brand new ball game. And now look at the situation. You got plenty of time on the clock. Defensively, they have three timeouts. So do you run the football here or do you throw it?
I think you have that full conversation with your offensive unit. And you tell them, here's the situation. They've got all their timeouts, so we are not going to play this conservatively. We've got to attack them. We've got to make them use those, gain the ground that we need in order to put this game away. If you think we're just going to run it three times and punt it, you got another thing coming.
Yeah, and by the way, also the two-minute warning in play, so essentially four timeouts left.
They have to be aggressive here.
They keep on the ground with Elliott, and he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. Tackle made there by Traven Howard.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Now Prescott. Letting one fly deep for Cooper. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off at the 23. And the Rams are right back in this football game. A seismic shift in momentum here in the fourth quarter. That's the break that the defense needed.
And you know as well as I do, people are going to question the play call in that situation. Sometimes you have to question the execution, not necessarily the call. And in this case, those defenders found a way to give their team a chance.
Now it's Stafford. And Woods has it complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Tell you what, partner, after he ices down, he's going to be a nice long soak in a hot tub after this one. He's been under duress the entire game.
And once again, hit as he throws. Fortunate that one wound up incomplete. So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. Now Stafford. They got a man over the middle. It's Woods. A field goal from this spot likely out of the question. They've got to get closer here on third down. Stafford now to throw. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. Well, forget the run on third and one. They shock the D and rip off a pretty big play. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Stafford. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they've taken the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Wow. How many people watching this one right here gave up? Because that score, they might want to try and rush back into this stadium.
Yeah, what looks like is going to be the game-deciding score, although with a bit of time left, so you can't count your chickens before they're hatched.
Yeah, they better come back in here and watch this one, because you and I, we're not going anywhere. We want to see this one play out.
Stafford's going to try and throw for it. And he's got it. So the two-point conversion is good, and they add on to their fourth quarter lead. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And that
one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. One possession game. Time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation. But this is Friday practice every week of the season. You go over this situation, having to go downfield, limited timeouts, got to get out of bounds and keep the drive going and set yourself up. Defensively, you can't just lay back and let them do whatever they want. So it is a cat and mouse deal here. How much pressure will the defense bring, and how much pressure can the offense handle?
We're going to find out. Now Dak. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Probably time for two more shots, and ideally, they'd like to get the midfield or so they have a chance at a Hail Mary on the final play.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10. To throw, Prescott. He's going to let it fly. And unable to connect, incomplete. Now give him credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up 4th down. This defense looking impenetrable now. 3 straight incompletions. They're giving him nowhere to go with the football. Maybe a little frustrated back there.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. When you've missed on 3 straight, there's going to be some frustration. But now he's got to make sure that frustration is tough.
And the Rams got it. They bring him down. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And now possession will go over inside the 15-yard line. Now a 1st and 10 at the 11. Stafford going to throw it. Oh, what a heck of an effort there as he'll make the diving catch.
Well, this, of course, set up by the stop a moment ago on 4th down. And now that might be the score that puts this one officially out of reach.
That's a tough one because your hands are tied when it comes in the 4th quarter because you know you've got to make something happen. They couldn't pick up the 1st down. And after that, the air just went right out of the balloon. And you knew you were looking at a defeated team.
Charles, in this one, I think the storyline really, the 4th quarter coming into it neck and neck, but they were able to separate, put their foot on the gas, and get the win.
And since you mentioned neck and neck, I'm going to stay with a little bit of the horse racing theme. It was that close, and then really went into the gallop and finished it strong.
One more horse racing theme.
Go.
I am glad you posted today.
Thank you. I appreciate that.